Let's get started. In this situation, I'm viewing Wrike from the perspective of Valerie, the creative director of a sports media company. Navigating to our requested projects folder, we've just received a creative brief request to post a blog about the top five ballparks in professional baseball, which will certainly require images of each stadium on a list. As our creative team works to put together the content and layout of this blog, it's essential for our team to be on the same page in regards to which digital assets we'll be using. And this is where connecting to MediaValet is key. So I'm going to click into the Request Graphics task. And when I go to click Attach File, we're going to have an additional option to input images from MediaValet. I'm going to click into here. And this will give us access to a window into our DAM account with the list of either categories or light boxes to choose from. However, I also have the ability to search for image titles, attributes, and keywords. So here, I will look for ballparks. And we have five images with the ballpark attribute. From here, we can attach the files directly into the Wrike task to avoid questions or confusion and help ensure visual brand consistency across this project. So I can select either one or multiple. I'm going to choose all five here. I'm going to attach these files. These images are now accessible to anyone in Wrike who has visibility into this task. From here, I have the option to download the image. I can select for approval, or if I were to click the image itself, it would take me to Wrike Proof where I'd be able to add markup to that image. On the other hand, let's take a look at what the workflow might look like for uploading images into MediaValet. Moving on to the next task, editing and formatting. We have our graphic designer who has worked on and uploaded a draft of the hero image for the blog post and has set an approval for Valerie. So I'm going to click into this image here as Valerie just to make sure that this is good to go. I see, yep, okay, great, nothing I can really comment on. I'm going to approve this image. We'll approve it. As we go back, now what we're going to want to do is upload this into MediaValet. So if I right click here, it's going to give me this option, publish to MediaValet. And once again, this window into MediaValet is going to pop up again. I have the option to choose which category I want to put it in, or I can just click next and it'll just directly just publish it to the library. But I'm going to want to put this in the ballparks category. Once I click next, this is where I'm going to input the metadata. So this is where I'll put the title, enter a description, then from here I can add keywords. What I want to do is these are required fields, so I'll just quickly fill these out. And something to note here is that when I go to the attributes, the collection attribute has been automatically populated with MLB. And what just happened here is that I have the ability to link Wrike custom fields directly to MediaValet attributes. So this was actually a custom field that I had filled out in advance. So it really shows that there is this, you know, piece of automation that can really save you time in the long run. If you're oftentimes working with MediaValet, you can set up custom fields that you can fill in right within Wrike and it will automatically populate as you upload. So now that I click publish and confirm, this asset is now being published directly to MediaValet.